Hello, in this video I want to introduce you to the Annex Max Probe. Here I have the drop-in replacement for the people that want to quickly try out how it works. The Max Probe is a two-piece design. Here I have the microswitch part that will measure the build plate. The signal is transferred through the magnets that couple the parts together. The second part is fixed to your tool head. This specific part is meant to replace the inductive probe shown earlier. No soldering or custom PCBs are required. The microswitch is docked somewhere in your build chamber. When you want to probe, the microswitch is picked up and ready to measure. Once finished, it will unduct the microswitch again where it will be safely stored. Without microswitch attached, you are ready to start printing. What do you need to assemble the Annex Max Probe? You need some kind of wire stripper, a little plier, a small wire cutter, something to crimp a mill SM2.54 connector, some screwdriver of choice for your M.2x10 self-tapping screws, a scissor, and something as a heat source for your heat shrinking tube. The parts you will need are the printed parts, the cable, SM2.54mm connector, heat shrinking tube, screws, microswitch and magnets. Don't use the random switches you have laying around. Instead, use the Omron D2F type 5 switch. This one has the best performance of all we've tested. To build the first part, check the loft on the side to see which direction the microswitch needs to go in. Cut the center pin as this is needed if you wish to disassemble later. The microswitch goes inside the printed part snugly. Check the top and if necessary, cut the pins flush. Now it's time to push in the magnets. These are directly contacting the pin of the microswitch. For the second magnet, alternate the polarity as this will help undocking. Push the part down on a flat surface and use glue if necessary. Now you can put in the M2x10 self-tapping screws with the screwdriver of your choice. Once again, check the orientation of your part. These screws should be magnetic as they will help retain the part in the dock later on. If you want to use the dock detection feature, you need to bridge the M2 screws. This can be done by aluminum foil inside or washers on the outside. For the second part, you need to print part, some cable, some magnets and heat shrinking tube. The printed part has a rectangle cut where the connector goes through. This is the same for all Annex tool heads with baked in Mag Probe support. It is strongly recommended to always print a tool head with the baked in Mag Probe support. The connector will make direct contact with the magnet. For the sake of this video, I pre-crimped the male SM2.54 connector already on the cable. The connector goes down till about here in the printed part. The benefit of the connector is that it's rigid compared to loose strands. You can always play around with using different type of connectors you have laying around. Use the small plier again to pull the connector further. Cut flush whatever sticks out. Make sure the magnet will stick out more than the connector is cut. Push in the magnets again and use glue if necessary. If done correctly, the part should look like this. I added some heat shrinking tube to the cable. This isn't necessary, but it makes it look a lot better. You now have successfully built the Mag Probe. Check if the orientation of the magnets is correct. The parts should only go together in one orientation. With the Mag Probe built, we can continue to the dock. This part is about the same for every machine that's supported. The dock can be adjusted on the back where the heat inserts are. To start, press two magnets in the holes. These magnets should be pushed in as far as possible. At the bottom, you will find holes for the cables needed for the dock detection. This feature is an extra fail-safe when desired. The connector will act as a flat, rigid part. For the best results, it is recommended to use the Clipper firmware. Clipper now has its own Mag Probe module. Finish by adding the second layer of magnets. It is normal, the magnets are sticking out a little bit. At the bottom you can add some heat shrinking tube again. It is recommended to do this before inserting the pin. The microswitch should be held safely inside the dock now. The compact design makes it possible to dock and undock the microswitch in only 10mm. As there are many configurations possible, it is recommended to check out our GitHub. You can find our GitHub in the link below. If you need more help, you can always check out our Discord. Happy printing!